Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Bit of a weird place to be starting a vlog in the car. It was a bit of a rush to leave, to be honest. So yeah, that's why I'm starting this vlog now. I'm actually on my way down to London because I have a dinner planned, which is it's actually with my management and basically the other influencers that my management manage. And a bit weird really, because I've never actually met my own management in person. This will be the first time I've actually met them. Obviously due to COVID and all of that stuff, the closest we've ever come to meeting is over a Zoom call. So yeah, they've just organised this kind of big get together for everyone to meet and just have a few drinks and a bit of dinner really. So we're going to a restaurant called Rocker, I think that's how you pronounce it. Basically for like sushi, cocktails, that sort of thing, so right up my street, so I can't wait for that. I'm going to take you with me and try and film as much as I can, but obviously it's a little bit scary. I'm meeting a load of people that I've never met before, so you'll get what you get. I don't know how much I'm going to actually film. And then tomorrow I am heading to Bicester Village to do a bit of shopping, and I haven't been to Bicester Village for probably about, I want to say probably nearly 3 years I've not been. It's been a hell of a long time, and it's just one of those places that it's a bit hit and miss, so I don't know if I'm going to end up buying anything. I'm going to go see what there is. If I fancy treating myself, I might treat myself, but there's a couple of things in the like back of my mind that I want to look out for, but it's just a sort of place where you can't go with like an idea of what you want to buy. It's just what is there on the day, to be honest. But I'm heading down there on a Thursday, which is usually an okay day to go because obviously it's not the weekend. So yeah, I am heading to the train station now. I'm going to hop on the train and then I will hopefully check in with you and I'm at the restaurant, but we'll see. All we need to put on is the radio. I can feel the heat is rising and that beat is hypnotizing. I'm so sorry if you can't hear me, but we're just in Rocker and look how unreal the food looks. Looks absolutely incredible. Also, yes, I am absolutely double parked. I've got champagne, Whispering Angel, it's supposed to be at Bicester Village. Is it gonna happen? I have no idea. We've got to Bicester Village and we're doing, it's like the VIP experience. This was part of my birthday present, so feeling very, very posh. We've just had a glass of champagne out on the terrace and we're in, it's called the apartment. So if you do, it's such a good thing, like if you're into your shopping and fashion and stuff. So we're in this place called the apartment. It's not an actual apartment, it's just a very bougie building. But I had to vlog these toilets because, I mean, they're just incredible. Like, they've got all flowers down the outside. It's just very exciting. So I'm gonna try and film as much as I can. But yeah, excuse the vlogging in the toilet. I'm back from Bicester Village. I'm not quite sure how much I actually ended up vlogging when I was there. it's really hard to vlog and get your camera out when you're there. And to be honest, I was just actually more focused on actually shopping. So yeah, I need to sit down. I'm gonna sit down and give you an update. So yeah, Bicester Village is just one of those places that's quite hit and miss. It's just look of the day as to what they've got. You can't go there with like an item in mind that you want to find, because you just won't find it. You'll be very, very, very lucky if you do. But yeah, I really, really enjoyed it anyway. It was a really nice day. I had like some lunch there. It was just really, really nice. I'd say there was a couple of the shops that let me down a little bit, like Balenciaga. I didn't really think there was much going on in there. Off-White, weren't really a fan of like the stuff they had in there. But yeah, you could probably go tomorrow and they will have completely different stuff. So yeah, it just depends on the day. One store I was really impressed with was, it was called the Designer Exchange. It had only been there for 2 weeks, but if you are making a trip to Bicester Village, I really recommend you pay that shop a visit. It's basically where people go to obviously sell their pre-loved designer items. So everything there is pre-owned, but it's all pristine condition. And it means that there are some absolute gems in there. Like, I was looking around, there was like vintage Chanel bag. There was a Hermes bag for £70,000. Just sat there and I was like, wow. So yeah, there was a lot of things there. They had this Balenciaga leather jacket that I was looking at, and I was like, oh, very, very tempted, nearly picked that up. Another shop I really enjoyed was Fendi. I thought Fendi was really good. I went to Bicester Village with a mentality of, I'm not looking for anything in particular, and if I see something, I'm just gonna keep an open mind, basically. If I see something I like though, I wanted to make sure it was more of like a classic piece. I didn't want to be going and just spending like splurging money on trend pieces from Bicester Village. So I wasn't going to go there and come home with like a neon green bag, for example. I wanted, if I was going to treat myself, it was going to be to something that I could keep in my wardrobe for years and years and years and years. And as I said, just something really classic that's not going to go out of style, really. So that being said, I did buy a couple of things. So I'm going to show you what I bought. As you can see by that bag in the background, I did buy something from Fendi. But just before I show you that, I just quickly thought I'd show you what I'm wearing, because I really, really like it. This, it's like a knitted set from PLT. And I am actually obsessed with it. I love the, like, pattern, not the pattern, the kind of, like, design on the front there. It does come as a set as well, which is always nice. And then I've just teamed it with this oversized, like, granddad style blazer. This is also from PLT, but I just thought, yeah, this is an outfit. Really, really nice. But let's show you the good stuff. So as you can see, I did come home with a Fendi bag. And I found a little dog in Bicester Village as well. Hello. Right, I'm just going to pop you down there. Sorry if the light's a bit funny. It's a bit funny in here this time of day. So first thing I bought was from Fendi. And as I said, I really like the stuff they had in there. I was so tempted to buy a bag from them as well. They had this like crossbody bag. The strap was like the classic brown Fendi colours. And it wasn't like a bucket bag, because I can't explain it. But anyway, if you are looking for like a cool little bag, that sort of thing, recommend popping in Fendi if you go to Bicester Village. So I did buy some shoes from Fendi. As I said, so close to buying the bag. I'm not gonna lie, I did wake up the next morning thinking, should I have got the bag? I think I would have got it if I hadn't got the second item that I also got from Bicester Village, but I went for these boots instead. So I come in a little dust bag. As I said, I wanted to get things that were very classic, could be in my wardrobe for years and years, and I feel like these boots are definitely that. So these are the boots, and I just love them. As you can see, they're black. They've got a little heel, so I can wear them during daytime. I had a pair that looked very similar. Well, they obviously weren't similar, they weren't Fendi, but I had a similar like style of boot last year from H&M, and I absolutely wore them to death, like day, dress them up, go out in them in the evening, go out for dinner in them, And so I knew if I was going to invest in a pair of shoes for like this time of year, or be coming up to autumn, winter soon, classic pair of black ankle boots, you can't go wrong. I am just obsessed. They've got like the Fendi logo around them on here. I just think they're absolutely beautiful. I'm gonna give you a closer look at them here. So just so you can see a better look at them here, so that my camera will focus on them. This is the detailing along the side. They've got the zip detail here with Fendi down the back. I mean, I am just in love with these shoes. I know I'm gonna get so much wear out of them. I just think they're absolutely stunning. I'm so, so happy. And you actually won't believe the price that I got them for. So as you know, from Bicester Village, everything is discounted anyway. So, but they always have like the label on to show you how much it should be. So when I went up to these boots, they had the label on and their RRP, like original price, was £900. So I was like, wow, I wonder what the Bicester Village price is going to be. And the Bicester Village price was half price at £450. So I was like, wow, half price for a pair of classic boots that's going to be in my wardrobe forever. Do you know what? I really hope any Friends fans, I hope this isn't like a Monica Geller moment when she has her new boots that she swears she's going to wear them all the time and then they really hurt her. I did try them on when I was in there and they felt really comfortable, but I'm justifying it, the expensive pair of boots, because they're going to be in my wardrobe for years. Let's see. But anyway, they were really comfy. But yeah, £450 for these boots. I was like, do you know what? Sold. I'm going to have them. I'm going to treat myself, my new winter boots. Got up to the till, got up there ready to pay, and they said, oh, these are actually half price today. And I thought he just meant like the half price discount that was already applied. And I just said, oh yeah, I know. Like, I'd already saw they were half price down from £900. And he was like, yes, that'll be £225. I was like, okay. Quickly paid in case it was some sort of mistake. Paid for them, got out of the shop and was just like, wow. So I got a pair of 900 pair boots for £200. Very, very, very happy. I feel like you'd pay half of that at Zara for a really good pair of boots. You know, like when they have those boots in for like £99. £200. I was over the moon. So yeah, that's my new boots. And then, I felt this is the grand finale. I bought something else from the designer exchange, so I can't actually probably show it you sat down, so I'm gonna show it you while it's hanging up. So this is the other thing I bought, and it is a classic Burberry trench coat. I absolutely love Burberry trench coats. I think they are just an absolute staple. Love them so much. You can see on the inside, you can see it's got the Burberry logo on the inside, the classic Burberry pattern that we've all seen. I just love the colour, I love the style, I love the fit. I actually tried on a Burberry trench coat in Bicester Village about 4 years ago and really, really liked it. It wasn't the long version, but I really liked it. But at the time I was just like, I can't afford this for a trench coat. So I left it there, but it's kind of always played on my mind since, and I've always known that one day I wanted to own a Burberry trench. So when I went in there, I tried this on and it was just perfect. It was the only one they had in there and I was just obsessed. So I'm gonna quickly try it on so you can see it. Now, obviously I wouldn't choose to wear a little knitted cord usually under a trench coat, but this is just, I hope you can just get the feel of how gorgeous this is. I love wearing trench coats open like this, but you can obviously tie this and cinch in. But it is just absolutely stunning. It's like the perfect length on the sleeves, perfect length, oh, no shoes on, so this really isn't doing it justice, but perfect length on the bottom. As I said, I'm quite tall, I'm 5'8". So the last thing I want is my trench coats coming up short and making me feel like I've got a little weird trench style dress on, if that makes sense. But this is just absolutely gorgeous. So I can't wait. I know I don't want to wish summer away, but I actually can't wait for the temperature to drop so that I can just go out in my little trench coat because she's just gorgeous, and I'm so happy that I finally own one because, yeah, as I said, I've wanted one for 4 years now and the day has finally come. So I've just got an outfit in mind for this. I want to wear my black leather leggings, my black t-shirt, my new black Fendi boots, my new Burberry trench coat, and just waltz around. And now I've shown you what I bought from Bicester Village, I'm gonna go downstairs because there's some eclairs in the fridge and I have no self-control today. So yeah, cup of tea and eclair it is. Oh my God, I know I said I had eclairs in the fridge, but look at the size of that. Desi, there's a little bit of cream on there. You can have a little bit. Oh wow, there you go. Is that nice? Oh dear, look at your face. Is that yummy? Is that yummy? Okay, so I've just had an order from Cherries arrive, and oh my God, you're actually not going to believe how much stuff I managed to get. I basically went a bit wild and did like a big cleaning haul with a few little foodie bits, but look at all this stuff that has arrived. And by the way, this all came to just under 50 quid. How good is that? If you've not heard of Cherries, honestly, check them out. There's like this isn't an ad, by the way. You just like shop on their app and there's always loads of really, really good deals. I love like getting cleaning stuff from them is so good. As I said, this isn't an ad, but they were really kind enough to give me a discount code. I will pop my Instagram code up on the screen now. But look at all this. Does this not just really like motivate you to clean the house? Like, we've got some Febreze fabric spray, some Astonish kitchen cleaner, we've got the Pink Stuff bathroom foam, which I love, Astonish, the window and glass cleaner, I've got some Fabulosa, Zaflora, I got a new Dishmatic for the sink with some new heads for it. There's a little minky cloth in there. There is just everything. I even got Desi some poo bags and even, you know, grab myself some bits as well. And then also they do these really, really good, like skinny, I hate that word for food, but these like skinny treats. So like, they're obviously all really low calorie. So these basically taste like Jaffa cakes. So skinny whips, skinny crunch, skinny cookies, just really good for like sticking in your gym bag and taking with you if you want a little treat. And obviously gold bars, absolute fave. I've left you a discount code anyway. That actually gives you 20% off your first order. So as I said, this all came to just under 50 quid. So this, you could get all of this with my discount code for under 40 quid, which is absolute bargain. I now need to find a place for all of this. I think I'm gonna clean out that cupboard. So yeah. Anyway, before I tackle the cleaning and the under sink cupboard, I'm gonna have some lunch because I'm absolutely starving. I got these things from M&S. You might have seen my naughty chocolate eclairs yesterday. So, because it's all about balance, I got this healthy little lunch for me today. M&S chicken katsu poke bowl. And it just looks absolutely incredible. So this is my lunch for today. Just so you can see a better look at it, this is what it looks like. So chicken katsu, all the good veggies, and it's got this like curried mayonnaise dressing. So I'll give you my verdict. Right, I did just mix all this up, so it no longer looks quite as appetizing, but I just tried some of the curried mayonnaise, the dressing that comes with it. Oh my God, it's incredible. If you like like chicken katsu curry and that sort of stuff, you will really, really enjoy this. Highly recommend. Go and grab yourself one of these. Literally looks like a dog's dinner now, but highly recommend go and get yourself one of these from M&S as a little treat for when you can't be bothered. Oh, I've gone really dark. For when you can't be bothered to make yourself some lunch. Desi, are you gonna keep me company while I have my lunch, darling? Course you will. Right, I didn't end up cleaning out my cupboard today, by the way. I just didn't have time to actually clear it out. I might fit that in on this vlog, or it might happen on another vlog. I don't know, we'll see. I need to see how long this vlog is first. So yeah, that's gonna be for another day. I have filmed a video today, had a really good productive day. I feel like this vlog, by the way, has been a little bit chaotic, and I've been a bit here, there and everywhere, but to be completely honest, that's how my week has been this last week. I feel like I've been here, there, everywhere. So yeah, sorry about that, but I feel like I've just tried to show you a little bit of everything. Anyway, I am going to the gym this evening. I've got a gym class booked. I'm doing legs, bums and tums with Dion. So we're gonna do that, and then I think we're gonna have a swim or do sauna, that sort of thing, which would be nice. But I'm just popping out, so that's in about an hour and a half. I've got to go and pick Dion up. But I'm popping to the shops now because I want to get Dee a little something, because I noticed that she hit 200k on Instagram, which is very exciting. And I feel like in this kind of like industry, it's, you know, me and Dion both came from working in office jobs. And like, people celebrate your birthday with you, and if you get a promotion or if you do something well, there's a lot of people around you kind of to pat you on the back and say well done. Whereas in this one, it's kind of just, it's like any self-employed person, if something goes well, you're just reliant on those around you. So I want to just go. I don't exactly know what I'm gonna get. I think I'm gonna get like a little cake or something and see if I can get like 200k in like candles to write on it, so that when I go and pick her up for the gym, I'm waiting with a little cake and it'll be quite cute. But yeah, I don't know what they're gonna have there, so I am just gonna go and see. So let's head to the shops, hopefully they've got something. But yeah, she's not mentioned it to me, I've not mentioned it to her, so either she thinks I don't know, or she thinks I have seen and I just don't care, which is horrible. So yeah, let's just see what they've got. I'm taking on a little drive with me now. How fun is this? Right, I'm back, and oh, that lighting is not very good, but I'm absolutely buzzing, guys, because I just went to buy a sugar-free Red Bull and I got refused because I didn't have any ID, and apparently it's challenge 25 for Red Bull. I had no idea. And she was like, sorry, down at 25. And I was like, oh my god, can I kiss you? Like, what a great day. I mean, the Red Bull wasn't even for me, so I don't care, keep it. Right, let me show you what I got, D. I was looking at the cakes, but they were all like huge birthday cakes. And I was like, that's a bit over the top. I mean, D, you've hit 200k, not a million. Let's keep her in a box. Let's keep her humble. So I got these. They're just cute little like cupcakes. And then I got some little like numbers. 200 to pop on them, so that when she gets in the car, when I pick her up to go to the gym, I'll just be waiting here all cute with the cupcakes. I'll try and video it as well if I remember. I will remember. I'll try and get it on video as well. So hopefully the next time you see me, I'll be ready to go to the gym. Right, guys, I have literally just had to do the maddest dash to take my makeup off, get the cakes like ready. I can't put the candles on until I'm outside a house. So I'm literally gonna have to shove the candles on and then try and light them within about 3 seconds. So there could potentially be like a fire. I think I could potentially set my own head on fire. So if I do that, I mean, it'll make like great vlog content. So either way, we're all winning. I need to move the camera around actually, so that you're able to see her. Right, I'll do that now. Right, I've moved you around so you can see her when she gets in. Oh my god, why am I so stressed? Oh my god, panic. What a panic. Right, 200. Oh my god, there's like cake shit all over the seat. No. Oh my god, she's coming. Guys, she's coming. Shit. Guys, she's coming. She's here. She's here. I couldn't.
Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god.
There's cake shit.
That's gone. Oh my god, the fitness box. Why is the cupcake?
I know, I need to light these now. I was so determined.
I was looking out the window like, why is she down there? Does she not want to
look? Hi. Right.
Oh my god.
Pretend she's not in the car, everyone. Right, we're just waiting for Dion.
Wait, I haven't seen this. What's going on?
Anyway, hi!
Happy 200k! Oh my god!
Oh, thank you! You have no idea of the stress.
You see that on TikTok?
Oh, thank you! You look pretty.
I don't feel pretty.
You don't feel pretty, why?
I mean, cupcakes before fitness class, that's just me and you summed up to a T,
isn't it, really?
So, we're about to go and do legs, bums and chops now.
Thank you so much.
That's alright, my darling.
That is so cute.
Bye.